Okay. Welcome, everybody. This is Matt, and today I'm going to play three holes from my latest course, which is a recreation of Prairie Dunes, which is a real course located in Hutchinson, Kansas, USA. It's opened in, well, nine holes opened in the 30s, designed by the great. Late great Perry Maxwell, and his son recorded the finished the 18 in the I believe about 1957 58. We're gonna play three holes here today, as is my usual practice. I'm gonna play a par three, a par four, and a par five, and it just so happens today I'll be doing that in that order. So how about that? Excuse me. The first hole that we're going to play is number two, and this is one of the more famous holes at Prairie Dunes, probably the most well-known of the par threes, although they're all pretty solid one-shotters. But this one is sort of the most famous. It has a pretty wild green, so let's go ahead and give this one a shot. Oops. Back left pin. So I'm playing medium difficulty on the pins. 12 on the stint meter, just in case anyone is curious. Since the wind's a little in our face, I'll just stick with the 7 iron. Ooh, that's a good shot. It's a really good shot. Well, it's too bad that I have such a short putt because I kind of want to show off the contours of the green, which is one of the more severe greens you'll find just about anywhere. You can see a couple of the little ridges and stuff that define it. Get the original camera back. There we go. It's quite a break for such a short putt. I've tried to keep most of the pin positions on. Oh boy, that's a bad putt. On slopes of 2 degrees or less, but with this course, it wasn't always possible. These greens are just insanely difficult. Yeah, save par. All right, so the next hole is the eighth, and this is another one of the more famous holes at Prairie Dunes, and also one of the original nine. All three of the holes I'm playing are actually were part of the original nine, which were Perry's. Nine holes, and as you can see, this is a rather undulating fairway. This is a really attractive par four, I think. I know Tom Watson said it's one of his favorite holes in the world. .471 today with the back pin, so it's a long. It's like all you want in a par four. Clubhouse in the background there. I'll stick with that since the wind's a little bit helping. Overcooked a tad. It's actually one of the more benign pin positions on the screen. This screen is pretty wicked too in places. Ooh, go in, go in. Ah! Actually, left myself a little bit of meat on that bone. Alright. On to the final hole for today, which is number 17. This is one of only two par 5s. It's a par 70 course, so there's one on each 9, and they're both actually fairly short. They're both around 515, 520 yards, so they're very reachable, but the primary defense, as with many of the holes of Preludes, is just the green complexes. They're very a little smaller than average, and they feature some pretty wicked slopes. So, course itself is not a long course. It's probably maxes out just under 7,000. So it's really not a long course, but so the greens are really the primary defense. Miles an hour in my face, so we'll hit the hybrid here and see how we go. So Perry Maxwell doesn't have that many courses to his name, but just come up short there. The ones he's done are fairly well known. Like, he's known for Colonial in Texas and Southern Hills. And he actually contributed to a few holes at Augusta National. He's rebuilt a couple of the greens there. If you think of like number 5 and number 14, those wild greens at Augusta, I think he's actually primarily responsible for those. And I want to say he actually is the one who moved number 10 green. If you know anything about the history of Augusta, you know the original 10th green is closer to that big bunker, and that is a horrible shot. I think I say this in every video now, but I'll say it again. I'm not that strong player. Go for the flop shot here. That's not bad. Okay, well, looks like 3 pars for me. So, there you have it. Prairie Dunes. I just uploaded it to OGT tonight. That's actually tomorrow morning. It's actually very late at night here in Colorado. So it should be available tomorrow, and happy golfing.